Okay, ladies. We have to focus if you want to get those tag titles back. But we've been losing all the time. I know, but it's a new year. We got a fresh start, and now we can... Look, I'm sorry, Jazz, but this whole Lexi Bunny thing has me screwed up. I can't even focus right now. Yeah, me and Char have been so distant lately. I think we need to reconnect. So what are you saying? Perhaps we should take a break for a while. What? No, we can't. We're the only other team on this roster that can stop the Misfits, especially since the Bad Girls broke up. But we can't win until we clear up all this old crap in our lives. Exactly, which means I need to get rid of Lexi Bunny once and for all. And I need to focus on my relationship with Chad. But what about me? Jazz, you're an incredible athlete. You've got what it takes to be a champion again. You focus on that while me and Natasha try to catch up. So this is it, huh? Just for a little while. Well, good luck to you two. Hopefully we'll be back on the same page soon.
Welcome, ladies and gentlemen, to another episode of VGW2K19, the final episode before this weekend's pay-per-view, Fatal 4-Way. I'm Brad Johnson on commentary, and we have an incredible show lineup here for you tonight. In the main event, it'll be Liam Malone going one-on-one against Jacky Ross. And also, we've got another... Wait, look at this! It's Chaos attacking the Fallen backstage! Oh my goodness, Chaos. Chaos and the Clown with me, the Fallen, and Cake in a tag match at Fatal 4-Way this weekend. Oh my gosh, we're looking at the Fallen fighting back against Chaos. Oh my gosh. The Fallen and Chaos. Oh my gosh, look at that sweep. Taking Chaos off his feet. Oh, but toss right there into that, right there into that crate. Chaos and the Fallen have a long history. It's all going to come to a head this weekend at Fatal 4-Way. Oh my goodness, ladies and gentlemen. Oh, look at this. Chaos has got him. Going up for a suplex here. Oh, but the Fallen fights back. Taking the Fallen. Taking on Chaos and the Clown this weekend at Fatal 4-Way. Oh, look at this. The Fallen. Oh, wait a minute. Chaos. Oh, with a toe kick. Going for that German suplex. Oh, reversal by the Fallen. Oh, and a kick to the face of Chaos. So this guy gets security back there. This backstage assault led by Chaos. Oh, maybe backfiring on him. Right there to that window. Oh, just tossing him around everywhere into that chair. And the Fallen. Oh, with a chair shot. Oh, right to the face. The Fallen fighting back against Chaos, but look at this. Chaos may have him here. Oh no. Suplex to the concrete floor. The Fallen's gonna be feeling that one in the morning. Look at Chaos. Go for that drive-by. Oh my god. Chaos taking a breather. Oh, the Fallen is still down. But wait a minute, the Fallen, he's getting back up. Chaos better turn around. Oh my gosh, that super kick to the back of the head. Oh my gosh, knocking that crate clear across the parking lot. And the Fallen. Oh, throwing Chaos right into that car window. Thank goodness it didn't break. Oh my gosh, elbow to the face of the Fallen. Went for that bicycle kick, but oh, a German suplex by the Fallen. And the Fallen. What's he gonna do with that crate? Let's wind it up. What's this now? Oh my gosh! Chaos went clear over that crate. Down to the floor. Chaos and the Fallen still slugging it out. Well, here it goes. Oh, right there to the limo. Oh, and back into that wall. falling. Coming back. Those chair shots on Chaos. Look at this. Oh, Chaos with a bulldog to the floor. Right into that ice machine. Oh, and the clothesline. And look at this. Chaos returning the favor with those chair shots. Right to the body. Oh, my gosh. Down in the lower back. And here he goes. DDT on the chair. Why hasn't security come out here yet? Oh, look at this. The Fallen fighting back. And oh, another whip into that car. And the Fallen over that crate again. But wait, Chaos caught it. Oh, a huge kick to the chest. Nice roundhouse kick by the Fallen, taking down Chaos. Oh, Chaos just shoves him away. And he tosses him out of the way. Falling down on the ground. And Chaos has had enough. Oh, back elbow. Oh, huge clothesline by the Fallen. Taking down his tormentor, Chaos. Go for that spine bust, but all the way to DDT to the floor. Head first into the concrete. Yeah. And Chaos. Oh. Thrown into another car by Chaos. Fallen. Disoriented right now. Oh no, but. Oh, the Fallen's turning the tables on Chaos now. The Fallen with the. Oh, missed the neck breaker. Oh, but a super kick to the back of the head. Oh, this could be it here. But, oh, another DDT to the floor. The Fallen trying to go for that spine buster again, but got reversed. And look at this. Oh, my gosh. Chaos has got him. Oh, man. After this assault, will the Fallen even make it to Fatal 4-Way? Oh, my God. Oh, not the pedigree. Not in the car. No, no. Oh, my God. Chaos just took out the Fallen backstage. Someone get some help out there. Well, hopefully we can get an update on the condition of the Fallen after that backstage assault by Chaos, but here comes the general manager of VGW, Status Quo, making his way to the ring. Status Quo has been pouring on the announcements lately here on VGW. I think he has another one. Hello, VGW Universe. Welcome back to VGW 2K19. As we saw on last week's Road 2 special, Magister Domine has challenged Dean Freeman for the Next Gen Championship at Fatal 4-Way. That match is now official. And to make things interesting, there will be a Fatal 4-Way match at the event to crown a new number contender for the Next Gen Championship at the Royal Rumble. I have handpicked four superstars to compete in this match. Jacky Ross, Brayton Blackwell, Teddy Tofik, and Liam Malone. I feel that all four of these men are deserving of an opportunity, and I know that at Fatal 4-Way, they will not disappoint.
Hey, that was a great match you had against Freeman.
Thanks, bro. Looks like you're up next, right?
Yeah, hopefully I can win this number contenders match at Fatal 4-Way.
You will, Liam. I've been a champ here before in VGW. Now it's your turn.
Well, at least you're in my corner. Rick and Noah are still pissed at me.
Forget those guys. You worked your ass off and Stace forgives you. I think it's time you forgot about the Iscariot crap and move on.
Yeah, you're right. I pay my dues by busting my ass at this point. It's time for Liam Malone to get some VGW gold. At Fatal 4-Way, I will become the number one contender and go on to become the VGW Next Gen Champion.
Bold prediction from Liam Malone, and congratulations also to Jacky Ross, Brayden Blackwell, and Teddy Tofik for being in this Fatal 4-Way match at the event to crown a new number one contender for the Next Gen Championship. But up next, this match is going to be described as entertainment for the greatest Cruiserweight champion of all time, Luke Andrews. He's going to see his three opponents for Fatal 4-Way duke it out in a triple threat match. We got Sean Taylor, Leo Zapp, and Kid Loco in triple threat action coming up next. Sean Taylor with that surprising call from NXT 2 weeks ago. After Luke Andrews called him out along with Kid Loco and Leo Zapp for the Cruiserweight Championship, a TLC Fatal 4-Way match at Fatal 4-Way. Luke Andrews looking to cement his legacy as the greatest Cruiserweight champion of all time. And calling out three worthy competitors, I mean, I think that's a pretty great way to start, but can he back it up at Fatal 4-Way this weekend? Here comes the former three-time WWE champion, the protege of VGW Hall of Famer Mike Lawson, Leo Zapp, originally from New York Extreme Wrestling. He's been wrestling since the age of 17. But he's been in the business longer than that. I mean, he started out as like one of those ring guys who grabs the gear from the superstars back in New York Extreme Wrestling, back when he was 13 years old. Stayed on and, you know, helped put the rings together and break the rings down, paid his dues, and he's here on the main stage once again competing for the Cruiserweight Championship at Fatal 4-Way. Leo Zapp has been in this business for over a decade. He still has a lot to prove. But ladies and gentlemen, here comes one of Luke Andrews' greatest adversaries in VGW history, Kid Loco. Came close to becoming Cruiserweight champion months ago, but still came up short against the greatest Cruiserweight champion of all time, Luke Andrews. Kid Loco looking to reclaim that spot, looking to reclaim the Cruiserweight championship. He is a former four-time Cruiserweight champion in VGW, WWE Cruiserweight championship, might I add. He's also only the second superstar ever to win the Champion of Champions title. The first superstar being Eric Daniels. Kid Loco back on the main roster of VGW, looking to continue to innovate the Cruiserweight division. All right, these three men are ready. We're going to get to see some Cruiserweight action here tonight on VGW2K19. The opening contest, triple threat action. Leo Zapp, Sean Taylor, and Kid Loco. Look at that moonsault landing into a backflip there. Oh, the drop kicks, but oh my goodness. Sean Taylor and Leo Zapp going back and forth. Sean Taylor, former NXT champion as well. The second ever NXT champion in VGW. Defeating the first ever champion, Kane Pemberton. But you remember Sean Taylor, he won the first ever NXT competition back in 2010. Oh, look at that drop kick by Kid Loco. Outlasting nine other competitors. One of them also being John Cook, who will be going for the Intercontinental Championship against Ronan Kevlar at Fatal 4-Way as well. Leo Zapp and Kid Loco back in the ring, trading shots back and forth. Going for a Hurricanrana and takes down Leo Zapp. Sean Taylor on the apron. Oh, look at those kicks. Oh, misses that forearm. But Sean Taylor, oh, takes it down with a springboard swanton there. Sean Taylor standing tall. Going back on the top rope. What's he gonna do here? Oh, missile drop kick on Kid Loco. Leo Zapp, oh, takes a drop kick of his own to the chest. Sean Taylor going for the Russian leg sweep. Sean Taylor's on fire here. Got a resurgence of his career here. Go for that. Oh, missed that senton there. Taking those dangerous kicks from Kid Loco. Loco's got him up in that power slam position. Hung up on that top rope. Oh, missed the kick there, but Leo Zapp. Oh, huge clothesline. Kid Loco taking some time to talk to the fans. Springboard kick. Oh, it gets blocked. And a hurricanrana by Sean Taylor. Taylor gets slapped in the back of the head and hit with a flatliner for his troubles. Kid Loco has his sights set on Zapp. Nice drop kick there. Kid Loco. He's got Leo. Oh, another one. Another flatliner. And Kid Loco takes down Leo Zapp, that flatliner. Oh my gosh, that springboard sling blade by Sean Taylor and a drop kick right to the face of Leo Zapp. Oh, Cruiserweight action is gonna be on fire at Fatal 4-Way. Oh, but look at this. Oh my gosh, that arm drag, hurricanrana. Oh, but look at Sean Taylor. Oh, overshot the springboard. And landed straight to the floor. But look at Kid Loco. Forearm to the face of Sean Taylor. Kid Loco getting back into the ring. Going for the cover on Leo Zapp. Oh, only got a one count. Sean Taylor breaks it up. Irish whip by Kid Loco. He's got him in the corner. Oh, what's this now? Kid Loco. He's got him in the tree of woe. Sean Taylor's in the tree of woe. Oh, we saw this a few weeks ago. Kid Loco's about to go coast to coast. Here he goes. Praying to the heavens, and here he goes. Off the ropes and drop kick to the face. Incredible coast to coast by Kid Loco. But Leo Zapp, oh, with that back elbow on Kid Loco. Reversing the Irish whip, and Kid Loco, he's got him. Sunset flip over the top rope, straight to the floor. Kid Loco back in the ring. Well, back out of the ring. And back in. I don't know. Is this Kid Loco? What's he going to do now? Sean Taylor crawling to the ropes. Oh, nice reversal. Back elbow. Forearm shot to the face. And Sean Taylor over the enziguri. Kid Loco doing the smart thing. Rolling out of the ring to get some breathing room from Sean Taylor. Leo Zapp back in the ring. And look at this. What's he going for? Leo Zapp with the reversal and a drop kick on Sean Taylor. Oh, look at this. Oh, tilt-a-whirl DDT by Kid Loco. Third generation superstar. And Kid Loco kick to the back of Leo Zapp. Kid Loco going up top. What's he going to do? Oh, look at this. Sean Taylor back on the apron. Oh, missed the kick there. And overshot that hurricanrana. But look at Sean Taylor. Oh! Hit him with a senton. Leo Zapp. Oh, it zapped. Sean Taylor just got zapped. And this could be it. Leo going for the cover. That's it. That's got to be it. Oh, but a kick out after one. And Leo Zapp could be setting up for it again. Watch out, Sean. Oh, he caught the kick. And, oh! Spinning reverse heel kick there by Sean Taylor. And Sean Taylor going for it. Oh, my goodness. Nice quick takedown on Kid Loco. Setting up for it. What's this going to be? Sean Taylor's got him. Here we go. Snake spin by Sean Taylor. Snake spin by Sean Taylor. And this could be it. Two, over the kick out by Kid Loco. Springboard, cross body to the back. Kid Loco may be dead, but look at this hurricanrana on Leo Zapp. Oh, with a spinning wheel kick, but look at that backbreaker by Kid Loco. Amazing reversal there. Leo Zapp, going for those clotheslines. Back elbow. Kid Loco, Irish whip. In the corner, but a reversal. Kick to the head. And Leo Zapp, he's got Kid Loco right where he wants it, but look at this reversal. Irish whip off the ropes. He's got him in the turnbuckle. What's this now? Neil Zapp did the same thing to Sean Taylor 2 weeks ago. That superplex to the outside of the ring. Here we go, superplex. Sean Taylor with a frog splash. Didn't get all of it, but he's still up. Oh my God, but Leo Zapp with the reversal. Sean Taylor could be in trouble. Went high risk. Oh, look at this, here it goes. Snake spin, oh, snake spin on Leo Zapp. That's gotta be it. That's it. Count it, ref. It's over, and Sean Taylor picks up the victory in this triple threat contest. What amazing action from all three of these cruiserweights. I can only imagine what we're gonna see in the Fatal 4-Way TLC match when the Cruiserweight Championship is on the line. Jeez. A lot of high octane action in this triple threat match. I'm sure it's gonna be even more to come this weekend at Fatal 4-Way for the Cruiserweight Championship. This is incredible. Who will come out on top? Will it be Kid Loco? Will it be Leo Zapp? Will it be this man, Sean Taylor? Or will Luke Andrews prove once and for all that he is indeed the greatest Cruiserweight champion of all time? Ladies and gentlemen, up next, a rivalry that's been brewing for a few years. Finally gonna come to a head at Fatal 4-Way for the United States Championship. We got Eric Daniels and Bash Robichaud. Two parts of a Fatal 4-Way battle coming up this weekend for the United States Championship, also involving Ryan Oxley and the United States Champion, The Bully. And here he is, the boss, Eric Daniels. Now, Eric and Bash have gone back and forth multiple times, but I don't think it's ever been this bad where they're actually calling each other out on Twitter. Also, if you remember on the Road 2 Fatal 4-Way segment, where those two were just beating the hell out of each other backstage, confronting each other by those Twitter antics. Eric Daniels looking to put an end to Bash Robichaud. And I believe Bash Robichaud just wants his United States Championship back after he lost his first offense to The Bully. Really holding on tight to the United States Championship. But how tight can he hold on to it when faced with three other adversaries? Especially the number one contender, Ryan Oxley, who definitely has to cash in his rematch clause in this Fatal 4-Way match. What's going to happen then? He's got three men aiming for that target on his back, so The Bully had better beware. Here comes the former United States champion, Bash Robichaud. Living by one motto, clothesline, flex, win. Let's see how many clotheslines and how much flexing is gonna get him to victory this Fatal 4-Way. Can he become the United States champion again? Can he prove that he is indeed America's choice? I know these two are ready to tear each other apart. Let's see what's gonna happen now. Nice toe kick, but a punch to the face by Bash Robichaud and a forearm shot. Look at this. Eric Daniels relentless, but look at Bash Robichaud with that Michinoku driver. Kick to the back, but Eric Daniels getting back up to his feet. Forearm shot to the face of Bash Robichaud and a kick to the gut. Oh, missed the clothesline. Got hung up on that top rope. Eric Daniels Going for that hard Irish whip into the corner. Both these men are very massive in size. I mean, look at them. Peak physical condition. Bash Rope Show, even on Twitter, called out Eric Daniels' past steroid use, which he has admitted and has given up on it. I mean, it's been over 10 years since he did use steroids. But, you know, he's keeping himself in top physical condition the right way. And Eric Daniels going for that hard Irish whip. Oh, my goodness. You know, Bash Rope Show came from the world of bodybuilding. Joined VGW back in 2004. Had a high-profile match against Status Quo, Quincy McDonald, for the WWE Championship at WrestleMania 21 after he won the Royal Rumble that year. Oh, look at that. Oh, misses the clothesline again. Gets hung up on that top rope. Bash Rope Show has never been a world champion here in VGW. He could be looking to correct that mistake. But first, he wants to start with that United States Championship that he feels that was wrongfully taken away from him by the bully. Bash Rope Show's got him up. But, oh, toe kick. Eric Daniels has got him. Shot to the gut there. Irish whip into the corner. He's got him up on that top rope. Eric Daniels looking for something big, but, oh, takes a boot to the face. And oh, my goodness. He goes for that spinning forearm there. But all right by Eric Daniels. He's followed by a toe kick. And Bash Rope Show, he's got him. But, oh, shots to the gut and to the face. Oh, look at Eric Daniels. He's got him up. Oh, he's got him up for that last ride. Oh, my gosh. Bash Rope Show is down. He could be going for that money clip. Can Eric Daniels hit the money clip on Bash Rope Show? Here he goes. Money clip. Got him down for the cover. This could be it. Two. Oh, but a kick out. Oh, misses the leg drop. Bash Rope Show taking advantage. Oh, look at this. Wheelbarrow face buster. The Bash Rope Show loading a little too early. Match isn't over yet. Oh, there he goes. Those clotheslines. Oh, look at the reversal there. Eric Daniels going for a German suplex. The Bash was too close to the ropes. Elbow drop to the back. And Bash Rope Show back up to his feet. Oh, misses the clothesline. Going for the cover. Look at that. Not even one count. America's Choice, Bash Rope Show. Looking frustrated. Tired of going back and forth with Eric Daniels. But, oh, look at that huge clothesline. This Bash Rope Show is the only one with a monstrous clothesline. Going for that knife edge shot, but he missed. Missed the headbutt. Got reversed into a jawbreaker. Eric Daniels. Oh, wait. Look at that shoulder check by the both of them. Oh, but look at this. Oh, that rib breaker into a power slam. Knees to the ribs. Gotta hurt. And look at this. All those shots to the ribs again. And, oh, look at the disrespect. Those push-ups on the back of Eric Daniels. And Bash Rope Show going for that beach bash. But look at this reversal. Eric Daniels, here he goes. Wait a minute, money clip out of nowhere. Oh, look at this, pump it up. Eric Daniels pumps it up, then drops it down on Bash Rope Show. Look at that elbow drop. It, it's over. Eric Daniels just defeats Bash Rope Show here tonight. What a match. All the machismo in the world surrounding this square circle when these two men entered in it tonight. Eric Daniels comes out on top with the ultimate flex on Bash Rope Show. But let's see which one of these men will be able to become the United States champion at Fatal 4-Way. Oh man, this mid-card title division is starting to heat up a little bit. And also, same thing goes for the tag team division. When one half of the tag team champions, Mr. Grass, goes one-on-one against Aaron Abbott of the Lone Wolves, coming up next. Two-time VGW Tag Team Champions Team Blaze Brass, headlining two Christmas Slams in a row. Brandon Blaze and Mr. Grass definitely put the VGW Tag Team Division on the map. What's gonna happen when they take on the number contenders? The Meme Express, Nate Express, and Rhett Kirschner at Fatal 4-Way. Oh man. But how is Mr. Grass gonna fare against the monster of the Lone Wolves, Aaron Abbott? Two big men clashing in the ring here tonight. Oh my goodness, you know, the Lone Wolves are definitely looking for those tag team titles. It's eluded them all this time, but it's eluded them once again. They were taken out of the tag team tournament by the Meme Express in surprising fashion. But will the Lone Wolves be able to get back in that title picture? Dean Freeman, the next gen champion. You just heard the announcements that he will be going one-on-one against Magister Domine for the next gen championship. I wonder how that match is gonna go. Will the Wolves be involved? I mean, that's probably the only way that Dean Freeman may be able to retain the championship. Because Magister Domine is one dangerous individual. But enough about that match, let's talk about this one here. Aaron Abbott versus Mr. Grass. Who's going to come out on top? Who's going to have all the momentum going into Fatal 4-Way this weekend? All right, the bell's been rung, and Aaron Abbott approaching Mr. Grass, but gets caught with an uppercut there. Throat thrust, blocks the chop of the, ooh, nice shot to the face, and oh, the STO. Aaron Abbott, he's got him. Trading chops back and forth. Aaron Abbott, oh! Takes a knee to the face by Mr. Grass. Brandon Blaze and Rick Christopher both looking on at their respective tag partners. Nice DDT by Aaron Abbott. Aaron Abbott bursts on the scene. The very first official NXT call-up. Burst on the scene at Battle of Olympus last year. Aiding his Lone Wolf brethren in retaining the next gen championship against Charles Dante Dillinger. Oh, look at this Irish whip by Mr. Grass. Headbutt. The headbutt takes it down. Look at the springboard. Oh my gosh, every time I see it, the athleticism of Mr. Grass always excites me. This is incredible. Not a lot of high flying big men in this industry, but Mr. Grass is definitely one of the more exciting ones. Oh, but look at this suplex here. Mr. Grass with a reversal. Off the ropes and, oh, that nice forearm there. And the nice kip up. Aaron Abbott off his rocker a little bit. But look at the springboard here. Oh, hits him with the crossbody. That springboard plancha taking down Aaron Abbott. Two. But, oh, wait a minute. Mr. Grass attacking Rick Christopher. Three. Getting the jump on the Lone Wolves here, but Aaron Abbott didn't take too kindly to that. Oh, right into the barricade. Referee with the ring out count going up on four. Aaron Abbott back in the ring. Watch out for Rick Christopher behind you. Springboard crossbody misses. Takes out the referee. And Aaron Abbott taking advantage. Oh, look at this. Aaron Abbott. Oh, look at Rick Christopher over there. I think he's getting a chair. Throws a chair into the ring. Oh, look at this. Oh, that leg drop on Aaron Abbott. Brandon Blaze cheering on his partner. Irish whip into the corner. And Mr. Grass, he's got him up. Up on the top rope. Oh, what's this now? Oh my gosh, what's this? Oh, huge. Oh my gosh, huge overhead toss off the turnbuckle. I think the ring just shook a little bit. Look at Rick Christopher. Once again, distracted Mr. Grass from the task at hand. And Aaron Abbott's got the side slam going. Oh! Right there on the canvas, Mr. Grass is down. And Aaron Abbott could be setting up for something huge here. Going for that jackknife powerbomb of his. But look at this, reversed into a DDT. Missed the grass back up. Oh no, he's over the top. He's up the top. Going for a moonsault here. Oh no. Moved his legs out of the way. I think Mr. Grass landed on that chair a little bit. But look at this DDT. Look at the distraction by Rick Christopher. Aaron Abbott with that reversal. And Mr. Grass went for that moonsault. I should be into the corner. And Aaron Abbott, he's got him. But oh, nice reversal. And another reversal. Aaron Abbott and Mr. Grass going back and forth. The referee getting rid of that chair. Shoulder block into the gut. And Aaron Abbott. Oh, another reversal. And look at this huge bill toss. Oh my gosh. He flies with the springboard. Also flew with that bill toss. Mr. Grass flew halfway across the ring. The strength and power of Aaron Abbott is amazing. Mr. Grass fighting back. Oh, back elbow. Huge clothesline. Aaron Abbott trying to put away Mr. Grass. What can he do? Springboard here. Grass lands on his feet. And, oh, look at that clothesline there. And a leg drop. Rick Christopher once again getting involved. And Aaron Abbott, there he goes. Oh, a huge headbutt. Oh, another toss. Another toss on the big man, Mr. Grass. Aaron Abbott. Oh, look at this. Stomped on the head. Look at this. Mr. Grass and Aaron Abbott putting on one hell of a performance here tonight. Oh, look at this. DDT once again. On the grassy one. But look at this. Brandon Blaze. Interrupting. Look at that. Brandon Blaze. Oh, but look at this. Aaron Abbott. Can we stand up for that discus big boot? Wait a minute. Going for that boot. Oh, ducks out of the way. Took the waist lock, but got reversed there. Back out by Mr. Grass. Mr. Grass, what is he going to go for? Oh, reverses that clothesline. Look at this. DDT by Aaron Abbott. Man, the back and forth of this match has been pretty good here. Aaron Abbott looking to close it out. Can he put away Mr. Grass in this match? Oh my goodness. I think Mr. Grass may be hurt. Oh, he's setting up for that boot again. That discus big boot by Aaron Abbott. Can he take out Mr. Grass? Oh, ducks out of the way. And look at it. Oh, wait a minute. Jumping Jamaican judo kick of doom out of nowhere on Aaron Abbott. Going for the cover. This could be it. It's got to be over. One, two, and it's over. Aaron Abbott taken out with the Jamaican jumping judo kick of doom. I don't think I said it right that time, but out of nowhere, taking out Aaron Abbott, gaining momentum in their match against the Meme Express at Fatal 4-Way. Team Blaze Grass with a nice singles victory here tonight. Oh man, the Lone Wolves are going to be kicking themselves backstage. They want that tag team title opportunity. They're working hard to get it, but tonight, oh my goodness, the victory goes to Mr. Grass. Very impressive, Mr. Grass. Every time he steps in the ring, he never disappoints in his performance. But ladies and gentlemen, up next, we have a match that's going to be so monumental. Anthony Lennox calls out Magister Domine for a match here tonight, and Magister Domine has accepted it. Oh my gosh, nowhere contender for the Next Gen Championship. Magister Domine takes on Anthony Lennox. So, Status Quo handpicked me and three other losers for a chance to become nowhere contender for the Next Gen Championship. Well, of course I'd be in the match after ending Tommy Fusion's career. I mean, who wouldn't want to give me a shot? Now we got Teddy Tofik, a failed boxer who has proven himself to be as irrelevant as his NXT run. We've got Liam Malone, a good guy who became a bad guy, turned on his friends, stole the company, left and came back. Or Wait a minute, did he come back? I mean, I haven't seen much of him since Iscariot Industries. Last but not least, we have Brayton Blackwell, some fruity pebble hair wannabe who couldn't cut it as a singles competitor. So he teams up with some douchebag who's equally as terrible to show us that he can't cut it as a tag team competitor. Jesus Christ, what are you giving me here, Status? You're giving me an easy win here. Why not just give me the number one contendership right now and save these three the embarrassment of being beaten? I don't know how many more people I need to plead my case to, because Status, you know that nor Liam, nor Brayden, nor Teddy can hold a candle to the real Joe Jacky Ross. You saw my performance at Christmas Slam and you've taken notice. That's why you put me in this match. But I don't even know why this match is even taking place. I don't need it. Just give me the opportunity. But you know what? You want me to fight for it? I will. And I'm going to be the fighting champion that nobody else has been, because the real deal Jacky Ross is going to be the man to carry the next gen championship into the next generation of Call. Well, what a mouthful from Jacky Ross, who was announced to be in the Fatal 4-Way match to crown a new number contender for the next gen championship at Fatal 4-Way, along with Liam Malone, Teddy Tofik, and Brayden Blackwell. A lot of bold claims there by Jacky Ross, but you know, anytime he talks crap, he does back it up in the ring. I mean, we saw his performance at Christmas Slam when he took out Tommy Fusion in one hell of a competition. But here comes Anthony Lennox, a man who has defeated Charles Dante Dillinger 2 weeks in a row and feels that he should be going for the next gen championship and not Magister Domine. Magister Domine put out the challenge during the Road 2 event. And now that match is official, Anthony Lennox stepped in and said that Magister Domine doesn't deserve that opportunity. Anthony Lennox does. I mean, he did defeat Charles Dante Dillinger 2 weeks in a row, but if you think about it, it was with the assistance of Magister Domine. So Anthony Lennox is putting out the challenge to Magister Domine. The winner of this match will challenge Dean Freeman for the Next Gen Championship at Fatal 4-Way this weekend. I just can't wait to see this match right here. Anthony Lennox going one-on-one against Magister Domine. We know what both of these men can do in the ring. We know their monstrous histories in their respective careers. But out of these two men, who's going to come out on top? Will it be the unholy artist Magister Domine? Will it be this newly refocused Anthony Lennox, who's probably more dangerous than ever? Here comes the unholy artist, Magister Domine, who has wreaked havoc on VGW for quite some time. We haven't seen him in action since the final erasure, when he was defeated by Status Quo at VGW20. I haven't seen him in an official match since then, but now Magister Domine answering the challenge of Anthony Lennox here on VGW2K19. With his shot for the Next Gen Championship on the line. The bell's been rung. Anthony Lennox charging at Magister Domine with that boot. Oh my gosh. Anthony Lennox getting an early start on Magister Domine. He's got to. Oh my gosh. But already close out outside the ring. Anthony Lennox did a smart thing. Stay on Magister Domine and get on him early in this contest. Don't give him any breathing room. Oh, look at this. What an incredible reversal by Anthony Lennox. Take it on Magister Domine, but oh my gosh, what a reversal. Head first into the concrete. Look at those strikes by Magister Domine. Oh my goodness. Went for the boot again, but got reversed. Oh, huge clothesline to the face in the forearm, hit that jawline. And look at this. Anthony Lennox with, oh, clothesline of his own. Both of these men going back and forth outside the ring right now. But, oh, Magister. Oh my gosh, I have not seen anybody basically dwarf Anthony Lennox in this fashion that Magister is. But, oh, look at that cyclone there. Taking down Magister Domine on the outside of the ring. Anthony Lennox standing tall. He may get the best of Magister Domine here tonight. He's got that focus. Oh my gosh. Once again, Magister Domine is down. Oh, look at this. Anthony Lennox showing no fear. Oh my gosh. He takes on the unholy artist in this contest. Oh, ducks the clothesline. And Anthony Lennox may. Oh. Wait a minute. He breaks out of it. He's about to take him into the unknown. But look at this. Oh, out of nowhere. The hand that draws on Anthony Lennox out of nowhere. Put a kick out after one. Oh, my goodness. Magister Domine. Going up to the top rope. Oh, what's going to happen here? Diving elbow to the spine. Right in the middle of the back. And Magister Domine. Oh, probably going for that backbreaker again. But, oh, no. Nice reversal by Anthony Lennox. Anthony Lennox. Oh my goodness. Can he take down Magister Domine here tonight? Can he earn an opportunity at the Next Gen Championship? I wonder who Dean Freeman would rather go against. Anthony Lennox or Magister Domine for the title. But look at this reversal off the ropes. Oh my gosh, but Anthony Lennox is too close to the ropes. Dean Freeman, whoever wins this match, Dean Freeman has a tall order ahead of him in his title defense at Fatal 4-Way. Oh, but look at this. He's got him up. Oh, Anthony going for those multiple power bombs. Here goes number two. And a third one. Oh, my God. The Beast is down for the count. This could be it. Oh, two count. Man, Magister Domine being overpowered right now by Anthony Lennox. And a DDT. Look at the resolve of Anthony Lennox here. But Magister Domine. Oh, he's got him up. Oh, that choke slam. My gosh, what's going to happen here? Anthony Lennox. Oh, he's about to get hit with it. Look at that. That crab walk. That creepy, eerie motion by Magister Domine, setting his sights on his prey. Oh, as he puts him in, here he goes, the kiss goodbye into the hand that draws. Oh my goodness, you can't be serious. This could be it for Anthony Lennox. Could this be it? Two. Over the kick out. Anthony Lennox showing some resolve here. I don't know if kicking out of that move was a smart thing by Anthony Lennox or a dumb thing, because now that Magister knows that you're not going to be put down easily, he's just going to turn up. He's just going to turn up the pain, turn up the fury. Oh my gosh, those clotheslines of Magister Domine. Here he goes. Oh, huge lariat taking down Anthony Lennox. And Magister. Go for that backbreaker. Put it. Oh, look at this. Reversal. Yeah, look at this. Anthony Lennox taking Magister Domine into the unknown. Oh, my gosh. Into the unknown. That's got to be it. Two. Oh, but a kick out by Magister. Anthony Lennox almost had the victory there. Oh, look at this. What's he going to do now? Anthony Lennox. Nice shoulder tackle there. There's that clothesline. Shoulder back toss. And Anthony Lennox going for it. Spine buster. Anthony Lennox is amped right now. Getting ready to put away Magister Domine. Can we go for those multiple power bombs again? But look at the reversal. Another shoulder back toss. And Magister, what's this now? Oh, the hand that draws again. This could be it here. Two. Oh, but a kick out. Close call by Anthony Lennox. Magister Domine showing signs of frustration. What's he going to do now? Magister Domine not letting up on Anthony Lennox here. But Anthony Lennox not saying die. Not just yet. Oh, look at that. Nice reversal with Anthony Lennox. Go for that huge clothesline. Into the cover. This could be it. Oh, the kick out. Anthony Lennox. Oh, no. Takes a lariat to the back of the neck. Magister going up to the top rope. Anthony Lennox down outside the ring. Magister off the top ropes. Oh, blocks the clothesline. And Anthony Lennox got him up. Oh, but a reversal. Shot to the solar plexus. Oh, look at that back elbow. Anthony Lennox. Oh my gosh. Irish whip to that ring post. Stomping away. Magister Domine. Went for that punch but got reversed. Domine and Lennox outside the ring. Very dangerous place to be. Oh, face first into the steel steps. Magister Domine and Anthony Lennox put on one hell of a clinic. Anthony Lennox going up to the top rope. He usually doesn't go up top, but look at this. Oh, the clothesline got reversed into an exploded suplex. And that knee drop. This could be it for Anthony Lennox. Could this be it? Oh, a kick out after one. Magister Domine. Looking to put Anthony Lennox away once and for all. Anthony Lennox missing those big boots, but look at this, he's got him up. Oh, that gut buster. Military press gut buster. And once again, Magister set his sights on Lennox. That crab walk signifying the end. This has got to be it. Anthony Lennox cannot withstand this entire assault here by Magister Domine. There he goes. The hand that draws. Oh, he hits it again. Third time in this match. It's got to be the charm. Can Anthony Lennox survive? Oh, no. Magister Domine. What's he doing now? Oh, look at this inverted Indian deathlock on Anthony Lennox. Oh, you can't push the knee that far. You can't do that. Oh my gosh. Anthony Lennox has no choice but to tap out. Oh my goodness. Well, Magister Domine is still going to Fatal 4-Way to challenge for the Next Gen Championship. But Anthony Lennox, what in the performance. Although he survived, Magister Domine, I think he learned a strong lesson here. Don't cross the unholy artist. Magister Domine dispatching of Anthony Lennox with some level of difficulty, but in the end, he is still the number one contender for the Next Gen Championship, and he will face Dean Freeman one-on-one at Fatal 4-Way for the title.
So, Dean, my main man, I've got a question for you.
Yeah, what's up, Rick?
You said that Next Gen title belongs to the Lone Wolves, right?
That's right.
And you said we, as in all three of us, were the Next Gen champs, correct?
Absolutely.
All right, so if that's the case, what was all that talk last episode?
Well, what do you mean?
You know, my title, my next gen championship, ring any bells?
Oh, come on, man. That was just champ talk. I mean, you know what I meant.
Do we now, Dean?
Guys, you're getting worked up over nothing. Don't let the naysayers get inside your heads. We are the strongest force in all of Kaw. Never forget that. Never forget that we are the next gen champions.
We?
That's right, we.
All right, Dino. I'm just making sure we're clear. You feel me? We're clear, right?
Crystal clear, boys.
Sweet.
Yeah, well, if that's the case, I wonder which one of those next-gen champions is going to be taking on Magister Domine this weekend at Fatal 4-Way. So up next, as a result of what happened about a couple weeks ago, Sierra will be taking on the women's champion Amazonia in a non-title match. If you recall, Amazonia defeated Vicky Malone in one-on-one competition, but then Sierra came out there and attacked the both of them. And Lodestar, of course, came to her aid. Now we know that Lodestar is still not cleared to compete, but she will be cleared to compete by the time of the Royal Rumble, which Stasco announced she will indeed be a part of. Sierra making her way to the ring. Her and Amazonia have a storied history going back and forth and off and on. But I'm figuring, I guess, Sierra's just trying to stake her claim to the women's championship going into Fatal 4-Way. But who will Amazonia take on the women's championship at Fatal 4-Way? I mean, it's this weekend. I mean, a competitor hasn't been decided yet. I figured that Sierra was trying to, you know, put her bid in for the title. Sierra's been a women's champion before, but the VGW Women's Championship has eluded her, and maybe she'll get that title opportunity in the future. And here comes both Amazonia and Lodestar. Coming out there together as always, Lodestar. Lodestar accompanying her wife to the ring. The women's champion of VGW. Look at this. Lodestar is crazy as ever. Always supportive of her wife, Amazonia. Amazonia put on an impressive performance at Christmas Slam, defeating the Lady in Black, Penelope Black, for the Women's Championship, retaining her title. So yeah, just like a question I posed earlier, who will challenge for the Women's Championship next? And another question, will it be a Fatal 4-Way? Well, here comes Sierra. She wants that Women's Championship. That's around Amazonia's waist. The bell's been rung, and look at Sierra. Oh my gosh! That huge lariat taking down Amazonia. The Women's Champ is down. Here we go. Oh, forearm shots. And those nightmare chops. Oh, look at this. Oh my gosh. Lifted Sierra up only by her arm. Dropping her down to the mat below. And Amazonia. Strength and power between these two women. Amazonia and Sierra is unparalleled. Sierra looking to get that championship. And look at this. What's Sierra going to do here? Oh, that falling powerbomb there, going for the cover. And Amazonia, not even a one count. Both these women are very dangerous in the ring. But who's going to be more dangerous when that title's on the line? Amazonia with a shot to the back gets reversed. But Sierra going for another powerbomb. Oh my goodness, going for the cover, but oh, Amazonia got the ropes. Amazonia slipping back into the ring, but oh, only be met with a full fist to the face. Outstripped by Sierra. Oh, shoulder back toss. And a kick to the back. Sierra wants that women's championship. She's about to do anything to get it. Shoulder back toss by Amazonia. Amazonia working on the arm of Sierra. All these women from Texas. Oh my gosh, back elbow to the head. And, oh! That flying clothesline once again. And Sierra going up on a second rope. Look out below. Oh, that crossbody. Incredible move by Sierra. Going for the cover. But Amazonia once again too close to the ropes. Sierra's in a rage right now, not really paying attention to the ring awareness. Oh, Fisherman suplex. Taking out Sierra. Amazonia's got her up. Double axe handle. Amazonia went for a forearm, but got blocked. And a nice knife edge chop by Sierra. Ooh, shoulder tackle. Amazonia win the women's championship at Battle of Olympus by defeating the now retired Junior Gresham. Carrying on the legacy of that women's championship. Amazonia going for an armbar here on Sierra. Can she make Sierra tap out? He's got locked in tight. Sierra nowhere to go. Both in the center of the ring, but that submission. Look at Sierra fighting back. Oh, he was shot to the face. May have strained some ligaments in that elbow there. Look at this. Oh, Amazonia. Go fat. Amazon bomb on Sierra. Here she goes. Wait, oh! Sierra with a hurricanrana. Reversing the bomb there. Oh my God, Sierra. The athleticism out of nowhere. Oh, but look at this. Sierra going for a power bomb around. Falling power bomb to the floor. Probably jackknocked the back of that head there. And Sierra, she's got Amazonia up. Drops down on the apron. Referee on the count of four for that ring out. Star looking a little concerned here. That hurricanrana came out of nowhere from Sierra. Look at Sierra. Another reversal. Elbow shots to the temple. Spinning back fist on Amazonia. Oh, it's got to be over now. It's got to be over. She's got her up. Going for it. Dark alley bomb on Amazonia. Oh, that's got to be it. That's it. That is it, ladies and gentlemen. Sierra picking up the victory over the women's champion here. Oh no! The kick out by Amazonia. But oh, knee lift. Taking out Sierra. Amazonia's fired up now. What's gonna happen? Oh, reversal. Forearm shot to the face. Oh, missed that double axe handle. And Sierra, she's got Amazonia on that top rope. Oh, but a reversal. Oh, what's this now? Fisherman suplex. Oh, but a rope break. Another rope break in this match. But this time from Amazonia. Oh, look at this reversal here. Shoulder check. And another shoulder check. The Amazonia. Oh, gets flung back to the mat. And a drop kick to the face. Sierra. She's ready to put it in to Amazonia's women's championship reign. Can she do it here? Weakening the armor of the Amazon. Oh, missed that clothesline again. Caught the kick. Elbow to the knee and spin it back fist. Could a victory over Amazonia here tonight get Sierra that opportunity that she wants? But oh, she was going for the main streets, but got reversed. And Amazonia. Oh no, look at this. Amazonia. Going for the Amazon bomb once again. Off the ropes and down she goes. Amazon bomb on Sierra. But a kick out. Sierra with an almost automatic kick out of that power bomb. Oh my goodness. Sierra with the reversal. There she goes. Clothesline. Sierra and Amazonia not playing games here tonight. That women's championship is very important. And Sierra looking to get a shot at that title, and a victory over Amazonia could result in that. Oh, that huge boot to the face. Huge elbow drop down to the chest of Sierra. Amazon is back up again. Went for that forearm, but got blocked and spin it back fist once again. And Sierra, what's she gonna go for here? Oh, nice reversal. Amazon with a shot to the back. Oh, shot to the face by Sierra. There she goes again. Going for that mean streets, but oh, another reversal by Amazonia. Oh, it's Sierra making a comeback here, but oh, STL takes her down. Amazonia. She may have her here. Oh, look at this. Oh, look at this roll up here. Oh my gosh, look at this one. Oh, but a kick out by Sierra. Amazonia. Oh, taken down by a clothesline. Sierra. Forearm shots. Knife edge chops. Oh, but there's a shot to the face by Amazonia. And another reversal by Sierra. Spinning back fist again. A stone-like fist across the face of Amazonia. Oh, reverses that punch there. And Amazonia, they have her here once again. Amazon, boom, oh my God, it's gotta be over now. Sierra is down and she's out. Amazonia is the winner here tonight. What an incredible contest this was. With the women's champion Amazonia taking out long time rival Sierra. Champion stands tall after this exhibition match. Who will be able to topple Amazonia as the women's champion? We'll find out soon enough. As far as we know, there's no competitor in line for the women's championship at Fatal 4-Way. We're them celebrating together, but look at this! Sierra and, wait a minute! Sierra and Penelope Black attacking Lodzonia! Wait, I thought Penelope and Sierra were not on good terms. But they're working together? What the hell is going on around here?
Whoa, hold up. I see that Penelope Black isn't finished with you, Amazonia, and neither is Sierra. So how about a Fatal 4-Way match for the title this Saturday? It'll be you, Sierra, Penelope, and, well, I can't choose Lone Star because she still hasn't been cleared yet. But who can I choose? Who can I choose to get? But wait a minute. That's Black Girl Magic's interesting, but who's coming out there? It's Jasmine Nelson. Jasmine Nelson, what's this about? Well, Jasmine Nelson, well, if you did see earlier in the episode, Black Girl Magic is yet another women's tag team on this roster who are taking a break. You know, Kelsey has to deal with Lexi Bunny, and Natasha Lassiter wants to refocus on her relationship with Melchar Caronto. So that leaves Jasmine Nelson, I guess, to fend for herself. But what's going to happen with the women's tag team titles here on VGW? Now that two of the main teams are broken up now. I mean, the only other team we have is Lodzonia, but they're getting caught up in this women's championship picture.
Magic is my pride and joy, but we had to take a bit of a hiatus. I'm not asking to be put in this match. I want to earn it.
All right, Jasmine, if you want to earn it, if you can defeat Penelope Black tonight, right now, then you'll be in the match at Fatal 4-Way for the Women's Championship.
Thank you, Status.
Oh, well, take a look at this. Since Lodestar can't compete in that Fatal 4-Way match, I guess Jasmine Nelson's going to try to earn her opportunity at the title here tonight. If she defeats Penelope Black, she gets added to the Fatal 4-Way match for the Women's Championship this weekend. I know Status Quo said Saturday, but it may have to get changed to Sunday due to time constraints. Oh, look at this. And Jasmine Nelson, oh, returning the favor, but gets her kick blocked. Look at this reversal here. You don't really see Jasmine Nelson in a lot of singles matches, but she's definitely a great singles competitor. We've seen it years ago. But now that Black Girl Magic
they're undergoing their own kind of crises right now. Jasmine Nelson's kind of like left the fame for herself. So why not go for the women's championship? Irish whip off the ropes. Got reversed and Penelope Black's got her in the corner. You still got Sierra and Lozonia out here. Nice drop kick by Jasmine Nelson. Man. Oh, look at that back elbow. So far, Amazonia will be taking on Sierra and Penelope Black for the Women's Championship at Fatal 4-Way. But it's going to be a Fatal 4-Way match. But who's going to be in it? Will it be Jasmine Nelson or will it be someone else? Jasmine Nelson with the Irish whip of Penelope Black to the outside of the ring, on the apron, and a shot to the face, knocking her down to the floor, and a springboard! Springboard senton! Jasmine Nelson is one incredible athlete. Let's see if she can win the Women's Championship, or at least an opportunity for it. She's on the apron. We're going to pull off something big here. Springboard and... oh, that crossbody taking out Penelope Black. I love the fact that Jasmine Nelson didn't ask to be put in this match. She wanted an opportunity to earn a spot in the Fatal 4-Way match. And now she's got it. Can she take down Penelope Black for that spot? Elbow shots to the back. Oh, missed the super kick there. Shot to the face and off the ropes. Trying to throw Penelope Black for a loop there. But oh, got hit with a super kick. Jasmine taking too much time to taunt. Got hit with a super kick by Penelope Black. Going for the cover. Oh, a kick out. Penelope Black fighting hard to keep Jasmine Nelson out of this match. It may just be a triple threat match if Jasmine Nelson can't pull off the victory here. And look at Sierra throwing in a chair. Jasmine with a reversal here. Here she goes. Hurricanrana. Oh, takes her down. Look at Sierra trying to distract Jasmine. Penelope Black still down though. Oh, takes a kick to the side of the head. Jasmine up. Oh, wait a minute. Elbow drop. Oh my gosh. She landed on that chair too. That could have taken Penelope out. Two, but oh, the kick out. What a great elbow drop that was. And look at Jasmine off the ropes. Going for that leg drop, but lands on the chair. Kick to the gut by Penelope. And a kick to the face. Penelope Black. Going for the Irish whip, but got reversed. And look at this. Off the ropes, but Penelope shoves her back. Irish whip. Off the ropes, but she's got the chair. Wait a minute. Oh, she threw it out of the ring, but oh my gosh, that dropped toehold right into the ropes. Goes Jasmine. And look at the choke. The blatant choke with the ropes. Oh, look at the taunt, just taunting Jasmine. Penelope, oh, takes a kick to the gut. Irish whip, and Jasmine with a drop kick in the corner. Penelope's still on her feet. And look at this, tripping her up. And here she goes, ankle lock. Penelope's had that ankle lock locked in tight. But Jasmine, oh, here she goes, kicking her off. And Penelope takes it down with a fireman's carry. Getting back into the fight here. Missed the super kick, and Jasmine going for a Russian leg sweep. Oh! Jasmine Nelson. Oh, here she goes. The twerk salt, ladies and gentlemen, by Jasmine Nelson. Here she goes. Oh, twerk salt. Going for the cover. This could be it, but look at Sierra. Sierra. Sierra interrupting that pinfall, distracting referee. But look at this. Wait a minute. Sierra's been kicked out, I think. Oh, that standard drop kick there. Sierra has been ejected from the match. Oh, no. Penelope Black still in this. Kicked out at two after that drop kick. Going for the Irish whip. Penelope in the corner. Oh, look at this strike to the back by Penelope. Oh, shot to the face. What's this now? Oh, nice arm drag there. And Jasmine fighting back now. Oh, what's she doing here? Oh, clothesline over the top rope. Oh, look at this. Jasmine, what the hell is she doing? Oh, that spaceman plancha to the floor. Could this be the surefire way that Jasmine Nelson gets a shot at the Women's Championship? Can she knock off Penelope Black here tonight? Oh man, she's out there on the apron. And Penelope. Oh, look at this. Got her on the apron. No, no, not that DDT. Oh, DDT on the apron. Jasmine may be knocked out cold there. The hardest part of the ring, reading your skull. Not a good combination. Oh, once again, taunting. Penelope Black. Known for being very dangerous in the ring. Very unpredictable. Did she take out Jasmine Nelson? Oh, nice dropkick, but it got reversed. The kick to the gut. Referee on the count of six. Now stripped into the ring. And Jasmine up on the apron. Going up to the top rope. This could be it for Penelope. Oh, wait. Oh, no. She caught her. Throwing a shoulder bomb there. Going for the cover on Jasmine. Two. Over the kick out. Oh, no. She's going up top. Because she's going for the black veil. Lady in Black. Penelope Black. Jumping off the top rope. Oh, no. She blocked it. Jasmine blocked it. Jasmine blocked the black veil, and here she goes. Drop kick. It's got to be over now. One, two, and look at this. Jasmine is going to Fatal 4-Way. Jasmine Nelson is challenging for the Women's Championship. At Fatal 4-Way this Sunday, not Saturday. It'll be on Sunday. But look at this. Jasmine Nelson pulling off an incredible victory here and earning herself a shot at the Women's Championship in a Fatal 4-Way match this weekend. Congratulations to this young lady. I expect to see an impressive performance from Jasmine Nelson this weekend in this Fatal 4-Way contest for the Women's Championship. Man, now it's anybody's game now. Who could be the Women's Champion? Will it be Jasmine, Penelope, Sierra, or Amazonia? We'll find out this weekend.
Atlanta Police Department.
Yeah, hello? Hi. I'm calling about a missing persons report.
Missing persons?
Yes, my husband is missing.
Okay, could you describe him for me, please?
He stands about 5'11", mm-hmm. almost 6', weighs at about 100, 200 pounds, soaking wet. He's got shaggy brown hair, a little bit of a, like a goatee with sideburns going on.
What's his life location?
Last he was seen, he was down in Texas.
Okay.
Name's Charles Dante Dilengar, 14th.
Okay.
Oh my God. I'm worried sick about him. I can't get his scent. I mean, I can't find him anywhere.
Stay calm.
He's been missing for weeks. He hasn't come home. I'm just worried about him.
All right, well, don't worry. We got your information. So we'll put an APB and we'll see if we can check him out for you, okay?
All right.
All right.
All right, thank you.
Have a good evening.
All right. Bye-bye. Damn it, Charlie. Where the hell are you? Come home, baby. Come home.
Now, what a precarious situation here. Charles Dante Dillinger has still not been found after Christmas Slam, but up next we have our main event, Liam Malone and Jacky Ross. Two men who will be in the Fatal 4-Way match for the NOAH Contendership for the Next Gen Championship. And that title opportunity will take place at the Royal Rumble. So whoever the champion is, whether it be Magister, Domine, and Dean Freeman, they will face the winner of that Fatal 4-Way match at the Royal Rumble for the title. Yeah, up first, we've got the outsider, Liam Malone. Got some encouraging words from his tag partner, Connor Riley, about going for this championship, getting this title opportunity. Now, Liam still hasn't, you know, gotten an approval from C4K, Rick and Noah, after what happened with the Ascara Industries last year, but I think if Status Quo can bury the hatchet, shouldn't they? Liam Malone has definitely been put through the ringer during his Ascara Industries run, but now he's being given an opportunity here in VGW2K19. I think it speaks volumes for Status Quo that he's able to forgive Liam Malone, especially handpicking him to be in this Fatal 4-Way match to crown a number one contender for the Next Gen Championship, a world title here in VGW. And I think Liam is definitely going to try to make the most of it, especially after being insulted by this guy here, Jacky Ross. Very brash and cocky individual here. Pretty much calling him out for the Scary Eye Industries thing. But let's see if those words are going to come back to haunt him in this match here in the main event of VGW2K19 as he goes one-on-one against Liam Malone. Liam Malone and Jacky Ross going one-on-one in this match. Oh, look at that clothesline by Jacky, taking down Liam. Jacky Ross just accomplished a huge achievement by defeating Tommy Fusion at Christmas Slam in a career versus career match. Jacky Ross actually put his own career on the line just to retire Tommy Fusion, and he did it. He succeeded. Liam Malone looking to, oh, look at that. The biting of the forearm there. My goodness. And, oh, Jacky Ross gets taken down with that punch. He slaps the face, and it is a Guri taking down Jacky Ross. Look at that. Liam just taunting Jacky Ross right now. And look at this Irish whip. Got him on the apron and missed a shot there. Oh, shot to the face. And look at Liam. Oh, that DDT. Nice close quarter DDT there. Through the ropes. And Liam Malone, he's got him up. Oh, look at this. Go for a power drive, but look at this reversal by Jacky Ross. Into a tombstone there. Jacky Ross getting back on top here. Toppling his main rival, Tommy Fusion. And now focusing on some world title goal. As is Liam Malone. Which one of these men will come out on top at Fatal 4-Way? Who will carry the Next Gen title into the new era? Three. Jacky Ross taking it to Liam Malone outside the ring, but Liam throwing it back into the ring, stomp to the back, and the outsider goes for those shots to the face. Irish whip. Got him on the ropes, and look at this. Oh, look at this. He's got him in it. Neck breaker. Liam's down after that neck breaker. Slips out of the ring to catch a breather. Jacky Ross. All against Irish whip. Oh, right there over the barricade. Two. Throwing him way out to the outside. Liam back in the ring. Off the ropes and bicycle kick. Oh, just took his head off with that one. Going for the cover. But oh no. Jacky Ross automatically kicks out of it. But what an incredible boot that was. Nice reversal there by Liam. And he's got him. Oh, that vertical suplex powerbomb there. Taking out Jacky Ross. Liam Malone. Look at this. Oh, go for that triangle choke there. Look at this. He's got Jacky Ross locked in that triangle choke. But Jacky Ross. Oh, man. Didn't let go of the submission. May have popped the shoulder on that one. Look at Jacky Ross. Going to that forearm shot. The reversal by Liam. That's that toe kick. But oh, here's a gurry. Slipping the back of the neck out of nowhere with that kick. And Liam gets reversed. Off the ropes to Jacky Ross. Oh, takes a kick to the knee. Back suplex by Liam. Liam Malone. He could be setting up for something big here. Going for the Irish whip. Jacky in the corner. Jacky Ross. Oh, get the back elbow to the face of Liam. Look at the reversal into a face buster. Jacky Ross slipping out of the ring. Looks like those words are coming back to haunt him. Liam Malone really taking Jacky Ross to task here. And look at this sit-out powerbomb on the floor. Liam Malone's definitely made some mistakes in his time. But he's banking good on his promise to make this change. His road to redemption is going to be a long one. But can he pick up the victory here against Jacky Ross tonight before Fatal 4-Way? And look at this. Jacky Ross, spine buster there. Incredible takedown by Jacky Ross. Taking down the outsider. Oh, back elbow by Liam. Oh, and another bicycle kick. Oh, my goodness. Super kick there. Oh, and that. Oh! One last shot by Liam Malone. Taking out Jacky Ross. This could be it. Oh, but a kick out after two. Oh, my goodness. Liam Malone. Look at this. Oh, stomping away on the body. Oh, the face. Oh, my gosh. Those boots to the face. And Liam. Oh, stretching the arm right there. Stretching that wrist. Pulling that wrist back. Oh, double knees to the back. Liam Malone. Staring down Jacky Ross. Laying prone on the mat. Here in the main event. And Liam. What's he going to do? Oh, huge boot to the face. Oh my gosh. And here goes Liam once again. Going for the last shot. Oh! Jacky Ross may be out, ladies and gentlemen. Going for the cover. Two. And just like that, Liam Malone picks up the victory over Jacky Ross. The loud mouth has been silenced for now. But will that silence stay after Fatal 4-Way? Can Jacky Ross prove that he will be the next next-gen champion? Or will either Liam, Brayden, or Teddy prove him wrong? Jacky Ross has a tall order, taking on Liam Malone, Brayden Blackwell, and Teddy Tarvik in Fatal 4-Way action. No more contention for the next-gen championship this weekend. Ladies and gentlemen, I'm Brad Johnson, and that's all for this episode of VGW 2K19. Tune in to Fatal 4-Way this weekend.